Hey everyone, my name is Kanaya and today I am going to discuss very important topic, that is Mersot algorithm. I will highly recommend to go through this complete video tutorial without skipping, because in this video you are going to learn a lot. Let's start. In this topic, I am going to cover the following. What is Mersot? Why we should study Mersot? What is Mersot algorithm? How merge operation works? Why Mersot is stable? And what is the complexity of Mersot? Then we'll talk about applications of Mersot. And last, we'll see some keynotes. So let's start. What is Mersot? Mersot is one of the most efficient sorting algorithm, and it works on the principle of divide and conquer. It works recursively, breaking down a problem into two or more subproblems of the same or related type until these become simple enough to solve directly. Now we know what is Mersot, but why we should study it? Let's discuss this. Why we should study Mersot? There are a lot of algorithms available for sorting, but most of the algorithm will take O(n) squared time to accomplish this task, which is not optimal at all. But Mersot can achieve this in O(n) log n time with the help of some auxiliary space. And stability is also one of the factors to learn this algorithm. That is the reason everyone should learn this algorithm. Let's try to understand what is Mersot algorithm. Mersot algorithm is a simple three-step process. Divide the array recursively into almost two halves until it cannot be further divided. If there is only one element in the array, it is already sorted and returned. And the last one is merge the smaller sorted arrays into new array in sorted order. We will understand each and every steps in detail, but before that, let's understand some basic jargon which we are going to use in our implementation. Let's take one example. Start index 0 is labeled as low and last index 6 labeled as high. Index 3 is mid and index 4 represent mid plus 1. We'll see how we are calculating mid and mid plus 1. Pay attention guys. This is the right way to calculate the mid index of the array. Please do not use low plus high by 2. It will overflow for large input. So always use this method to calculate the mid index. Now we know the basic stuff which is required to understand the algorithm. Let's understand the Mersot algorithm steps one by one. Divide the array recursively into almost two halves. Let's write a method for it first. So we have method name Mersot, which accepts three parameters: input array, start index or low, and index or high. As we need to divide the array almost two halves, so we'll use this formula to calculate the mid. Now we know the mid. Let's divide the array recursively. So we'll call the same method again but with different parameters. So after dividing the array, our mid will become high for the left half. Call the same recursive function again for the second half or right half of the array with mid plus 1 as low. So far we have written an algorithm to recursively divide the array, but it will go into infinite loop without a base case. So we have to add base case as well. So if there is only one element in the array, it is already sorted. No need to think at all. Just return. And how you will come to know there is only one element in the array? When you reach to the point where low and high both are representing same index or pointing to the same element, it means there is only one element left in the array. And single element is always sorted. So let's add that condition here. If low equals to high, then return. Here base condition is in if block and rest statements are in else block. As we are not doing anything in if block and simply returning the control back, so we can remove this if block and write the same something like this. If low is less than high, then else statement should execute. By doing this, we are reducing this conditional block. Because low will shift towards right side and right will shift towards left. And once both meets, it means we have traversed all element in the array. So far we have completed two steps. Let's talk about third or the last step. Merge the smaller sorted arrays into new array in sorted order. So here we'll merge the two sorted arrays in sorted order. Let's understand this merge sort operation in detail first. Then we'll see the complete merge sort visualization, merge operation. Here is the code which will perform merge operation. We'll understand this with the given example on left side. We have given two sorted arrays or partition inside the array and we'll merge this into one sorted order. First create the auxiliary array and copy all the elements from the given array. So this code is doing the same thing whatever I just said. Copy all the elements from the given array to the auxiliary array. So now this auxiliary array also has two sorted array or partition. Let's take three variable I, j and k, where I represent start index or low in the auxiliary array, j represent mid plus 1 in auxiliary array and k represent start index of input array or low. Let's run this for loop from low to high for input array. In first iteration, compare the ith index of auxiliary array to jth index of auxiliary array. Conceptually, both are representing the start of two different sorted array. So if you compare these two values, one is lesser than two. So we'll put one in original array at index k and increment j and k accordingly. Because we have put the jth index value at proper place in the array. In iteration 2, compare these two values. One is lesser than 2. So we'll put 1 in original array at index k and increment j and k accordingly. Because we have again put the jth index value at proper place in the original array. Similarly, in the third iteration, compare these two values. 2 is lesser than 5. So we'll put 2 in original array at index k and increment I and k accordingly. Because we have put the ith index value this time at proper place in the array. Similarly, for fourth iteration, compare these two values. 3 is lesser than 5. So we'll put 3 in original array at index k and increment I and k accordingly. Because we have put the ith index value this time at proper place in the array. Similarly, for fifth iteration, compare these two values where 4 is lesser than 5. So we'll put 4 in the original array at index k and increment I and k accordingly. Because we have put the ith index value this time at proper place in the array. Similarly, for sixth iteration, compare these two values. 5 is lesser than 6, so we'll put 5 in the original array at index k and increment j and k accordingly because we have put the jth index value this time at proper place in the array. In seventh iteration, there is nothing to compare because we have exhausted jth index. So now j is greater than high. It means all element of the right half or right partition exhausted or got placed in correct position in the input array. So let's copy the remaining left half elements into the original array and vice versa. It means if by any chance left half got exhausted first, we can directly copy the right half of the array into the original array. So we'll copy 6 at index k and increment I and k accordingly. In 8th iteration, loop condition will become false because k is greater than high. So control will come out of the loop. And see the original input array. It's in sorted order now. This is how the merging happens between two sorted array. Here, two sorted array doesn't mean it should always be two different arrays. It may be two partition inside the same array as well, just like we saw. We have seen this one array into two different sorted partition divided via midpoint or index. The same merge operation has to be performed in sorted partition recursively and form a big one, which will be used later for merging with bigger partition. Let's club all three step process together which we have learned so far and see the complete visualization of the algorithm with the given example array. On the left hand side, we have code and will trace out for you to make the things clear. Low is less than high, which is true. So divide the array into two halves and recursively do the same until it cannot be further divided. So we'll keep on dividing the array. Now let's divide this in next step. Here we have reached to the point where we cannot divide the element further. And low is equals to high. So this condition is false now. Now recursion will start folding and will perform merge operation. Let's see the merge code as well along with this diagram. Here 6 and 3 are two different sorted partition in the array and merging will happen for these two. And you will get one sorted partition which is this. Here merging is performed on left half. Now right half will be processed similarly. Divide the array first until it cannot be further divided and then start merge operation. Here 2 and 4 are two different sorted partition in the array and merging will happen for these two. We cannot see any change here because both are at their proper position or already sorted. Now we have two sorted partition or left side. So merging will happen. We will use the same merge operation which we discussed initially. And these two small sorted partition will be merged in a sorted order. Now control will go to the right half. For those who are not able to understand how the control is going, I would recommend try watching our recursion playlist. We have explained everything over there. And how the method call will put on stack and execution happens. Now left half will be divided first and merging will happen on left half first. Here 1 and 5 are two different sorted partition in the array and merging will happen for these two. We cannot see any change here because both are at their proper position or already sorted. Now right half will be processed. As there is nothing to divide, it will return the control and merging will be performed with the last left half, which is this. Here 1 and 5 and 1 are two different sorted partition in the array and merging will happen for these two and we'll get one sorted partition inside the array. Now we have done with the left and right half. This is the last step because now both partition or the array halves are sorted. One thing to notice here, we have two ones in the array and both are maintaining its relative position. It means the one highlighted with yellow comes before the one which is highlighted in blue in the given array, which shows merge sort is a stable algorithm. It will not change the relative order of the element if duplicates are present inside the input array. So once again, final merging will be performed to get the input array sorted, and this will be the final result. Here we have got the input array in sorted order. See the 1 minute animation video which is doing the same thing what we have just discussed. I hope guys, now you have fair idea of how merge sort algorithm works. Let's talk about its complexity. First, it starts with the time complexity. Merge sort will take O n log n time to sort the array, and we have seen that it takes space to sort the two sorted partition into one, and it can go till original array size in worst case. That's why it has O n space complexity as well. And here are few merge sort applications: inversion counting problem, external sorting, e-commerce application. Merge sort is also useful for sorting linked list problem in O n log n time. And there merge sort can be implemented without extra space for linked list. That I will leave it as an exercise for you to answer it. Now we have come to the end of this tutorial. Let's summarize the key points here for quick refresh. Merge sort algorithm works on the principle of divide and conquer. Merge sort is a stable sort, which means that the same element in an array maintains their original position with respect to each other. It takes O n log n time in worst case to sort the input. It takes extra auxiliary O n space. Merge sort can be implemented without extra space for linked list. We have seen a lot of theory now. It's time to see the demo. So this is the program guys, which we have already seen in the last couple of slides. So I'll not talk much about it. It is the same code which we have already seen. Right? So I'll just run this program in front of you to showcase whether it's working or not. So let's run this. I'll enter the number of elements in the array, let's say 8. Now I'll enter the 8th element, 3, 5, 1, 6, 8, 9, 0, -3. So now the sorted array is this. So you can see guys, this is the input array, which is a random, and this is the sorted array. That means our program works fine. I hope guys you have enjoyed the tutorial. If you find it useful, please let me know in the comment section.